like I should.
All right, thanks, Neil. Number 9, happy Monday. Let's talk about nut butter. More people are turning to nuts, especially if they're vegans. There are a lot of benefits of nut-based butters. They're high in protein, they're high in fiber, and contain a lot of good fats, the unsaturated kind. But the real reason for this story is a little tidbit we found out about peanut butter. The origin of all of the nuts, and in 1895, John Harvey Kellogg, the creator of Kellogg's cereal, patented a process for creating peanut butter.
Hmm.
He marketed it as a healthy protein substitute for patients without teeth.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah.
We don't think about those people enough.
Right.
Yeah. All right.
All right, number 8, we talk a lot about bears and hippos on this show, but let's not forget the birds, especially the rainbow lorikeet.
Oh, yeah.
That's a nice looking bird.
Just look at the color.
Yeah.
The rainbow lorikeet has some unique traits. Its tongue has brush-type tissues that help it collect nectar and pollen.
Wow.
And it has extremely agile legs that help it hang upside down to feed on colorful shrubs.
Wow.
Would you look at that?
Looks fake almost.
Beautiful bird,
right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, number 7. Fans of the movies The Breakfast Club, St. Elmo's Fire, remember Ally Sheedy. If you're not sure you remember, take a look.
You. Hey. What's her name? Wake her. Wake her up. Hey, come on your feet, Missy. Let's go. This is no rest home. The soft drink machine in the teacher's lounge. Let's go.
So, what's your poison?
Where's this going?
What do you drink?
Yeah, what's this story about, Robin?
You never seen The Breakfast Club?
Yeah, I've seen it.
Well, this story that I'm reading,
yeah,
it says right on the screen.
Yes,
I didn't even
does.
Have to say anything. Ally Sheedy is 59 years old. She's a college professor. She teaches acting at the City College of New York. She recently told People Magazine that some of her students recognize her, but others have no idea who she is, so she tells them to Google her. She's also starring in a show on Freeform called Single Drunk Female. She plays the single mother to a girl who is navigating sobriety.
That movie still holds up.
Yeah, it does.
Right? Number 6, you don't need an electric skateboard, but you might want one. You can run errands, commute to work, or zip on over to a friend's house.
Most or fall them, and break your hip.
Yeah, go 25 miles an hour, so they're not necessarily useful if you're trying to ride one on a busy sidewalk. But if you have some space to open things up, do it. They're portable. You can take them on the bus, the train. Here's the thing, they're not cheap. Most start at $450, and they can go into the thousands, depending on how much power you want.
Wow.
You ever seen someone zip by you on
no,
one of these?
No, no.
It's scary.
Yeah,
it's exciting.
Like, scary for you, or you're scared for them?
I'm scared for them.
Oh, really? Because yeah. It's 25 miles an hour. It's fast.
There's no protection there. You hit
no.
a bump.
Yeah.
It's a wrap.
Right. Right.
Isn't it funny that we're all,
it's
I mean,
all
they're
over.
Probably 20 years ago, we would all have been like, that's really cool. And now we're all just like, oh, it's very dangerous.
20, maybe 35.
Maybe 30. Yeah, that sounds about right. Like, I do remember surfing my bike when I was like 12.
Yeah.
And now I think the whole idea, the concept of it is just insane.
Insane.
Risk averse.
Oh, God.
Number 5, America's hottest city is Phoenix, and it's trying to find a way to cool off. How hot is Phoenix? It's so, how hot is it?
Oh, yeah.
It's so hot. I saw a dog chasing a cat, and they were both walking. Ba-dum-bum. Anyway, Phoenix is a genuine problem because the city is almost unlivable in the summers. In 2020, they had 53 days that were above 110 degrees. If people want to go there for a leisurely summer hike, they generally do it at night when it's around 94 degrees. It's mostly because of global warming and too much development. Downtown Phoenix has a lot of parking garages made of concrete, which absorb the heat and then remit it so that they are a heat czar.
Oh, right.
They got one of those. His plan is to cut back on concrete structures. They will also make things with less asphalt and more green canopy, like trees and bushes, and also add reflective surfaces that will help cool downtown.
Yeah, that's gonna make a big difference.
Yeah.
A lot of the places out there are actually putting up a lot of the generated power from the sun, like right. on those structures. So you say, okay, here's a way to do it. But yes, it's too doggone hot yeah. there yeah. in the summertime.
Hey, watch your language, okay?
Yeah, come on, Lawrence.
Potty mouth.
I don't know what you do on radio.
All right, number four. This is snow artist Simon Beck. He's a cartographer, you know, map maker. He sure. creates these perfect detailed geometrical designs in the snow using nothing more than a traditional compass, a map drawing, and a pair of snowshoes. Look at this time lapse here.
Look at this.
This is in Alberta, Canada.
Wow.
He partnered with Banff and Lake Louise Tourism. His designs are usually about 150 yards. Most of them require a 12-hour workday during which he will walk many, many miles.
How I kind of feel badly for the guy.
Wow.
I mean, it's a great gift, but...
But, I mean, does he take off the shoes and run back up the hill and say, do I have it yet?
Yeah.
Is that good?
How do you know?
How do I look? Does it look
yeah.
good? It's
Seems
all
lonely.
About the compass and the math.
We should just try this. And when it snows, it's going to snow this week, we could
sure,
try it
yeah.
and get SkyCam 9, send it up
yeah.
and see how we did.
Yeah, maybe we try to spell WGN or something. But I don't know how you get from one to the next without making... The tracks.
Right.
SkyCam 9 and a long rope. That'll do the trick. All right, number three. We have an explanation for another idiom. Cost of an arm and leg, of course, it means something is very expensive. And that phrase goes back to art in the 15th century. If you were a little rich, you might be able to afford to pay an artist to paint a portrait for you. But to get your arms and legs included, well, that's when the painting really got expensive.
Ah.
So if an artist quoted you a price, or quoted the price to a client, and it was too high, he might then offer to paint the portrait for less with fewer or no limbs included.
Really?
Okay, I was going to a much darker place
Me
when you
too.
Started
yeah.
that
yeah.
story.
Especially
yeah.
when you're talking about the Middle Ages.
Yes.
Right. You're, you know, you're yeah. chopping off an arm for a good
right.
painting.
Right.
That's what I was thinking.
Well, you know.
Paul bringing
yeah.
the sunshine.
Right?
It's
Listen,
great.
It's the least I can do.
Number two, here's a simple pleasure for you. Stock photos from the 70s.
Oh, look at that guy.
I had that coat.
I was literally wearing that suit.
I know. Look at this guy. Got a lot of work.
Yeah. All tennis.
Hello.
That guy's working a lot.
Is that guy a weatherman? Is that what that was?
Back when they were acceptable.
What's that guy supposed to be? Look at this.
Ooh, whimsical.
Look at this.
My dad had a better natural than that.
Yeah?
I'll bring in the photos.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah?
It's amazing.
Really?
Pictures of my dad's natural back in
bringing
the day.
Bringing it?
Yeah.
Oh, just out to here.
Yeah.
Yes. Incredible.
Was he rocking the big tie and the checkered
yes.
jackets, too? He
yes.
was doing it all?
He's a college professor, so I mean, he has like the...
Oh, yeah.
He's got all the stuff.
I
you ever thought
it.
Of letting yours really...
Oh, when I could, I
yeah.
did.
Yeah.
I'll bring in one of those scary
yeah.
pictures,
Come
too,
on.
Someday.
Yeah.
I'll bring my high top fade in here one day.
I love it. All right, number one, here's a good clip from the CBS station in Portland a few winters back. Just stay with it.
I caught up with Chelsea and Michael, who were jogging by, and were nice to just stop for a quick second. And I said, what are you doing running? And you're saying it was really good out?
It's the perfect texture for running. Very low impact on its dry snow, so your feet don't get wet.
What have you seen while you've been out running?
It's been a lot of fun. There's a lot of other runners and more skiers than runners, for sure. I think they've got a little bit of the advantage with
yeah.
the whole stride and glide thing. But it's too nice to not be out here.
Keep on the run. Sorry to have kept you, but I appreciate you guys talking with us.
Here we go.
All right, thanks. So we've seen a lot of people out here, like you said, running, sledding, just enjoying.
Whoa. Whoa. Man, that was a tough
That could happen, unfortunately. Looks like Chelsea's okay. You okay?
Oh,
oh, I don't think she's okay.
I don't think she's okay.
Let me go dial 911.
She hit her head, too.
Just enjoying it.
I mean,
yeah.
See, I don't like the falls where it looks like people really
yeah.
got hurt.
Well, this
she was okay.
Yeah, this
she
is a
actually
15-year-old
is done like podcast
oh,
about this
yeah.
moment and
she's emotionally
and everything.
Damaged, but
yeah.
that lasts as long as the physical.
And she still goes out and does that type of running,
yeah.
which to me is ridiculous because you're gonna do that.
Right.
Right. Yeah. I mean, outside
Choices.
Is dangerous to begin with, Lawrence. I've said this, but then
yeah.
you add some snow, and it's just, it's like you're
right.
risking your life.
But she's living. She got on TV. And she's doing podcasts now.
Yeah. That's the 9 and 9.
Sweet 9 and 9.